I've been using Oura Ring for over 3 years, and I got new third generation Oura Ring 1 month ago and been using it since. And now I'll wrap up what I have noticed from this new ring, what there is, and also how it compares to older version. Let's get into it. One of the first things you'll notice is green LED light between ring and finger. Green LED is one of the new LEDs and sensors there are. When second generation ring had infrared LEDs, third generation ring has green, red and infrared LEDs. Green is said to be for daytime and workout heart rate detection, and red LEDs are for blood oxygen measurement, and infrared LEDs are activated during nighttime for heart rate readings. With second generation ring, I noticed often that it was recording awake time as sleep, and if waking up early or between 4 to 5 in the morning for some reason, it might still show that you've been sleeping. But funny thing is that according to some studies, Oura detects different sleep phases very well comparing real sleep clinic data. So this is a little confusing in some way. If falling asleep fast and not waking up in the night, data might be pretty accurate. But if struggling with sleep in the evening or have some disturbance during early morning time but not getting up from the bed, you might get longer sleep time in app than what you have really slept. And what I have noticed is pretty much the same with this new third generation ring as well. There is still that app is showing you sleeping even if you haven't fallen asleep yet, and early wake ups is the same. But this new ring is set to come with new updated sleep algorithm, but at 2022. And there's no info of is it coming first half or later half of 2022. So we'll just need to wait. But I'm really interested about this upcoming updated sleep algorithm when it arrives. I will definitely be checking that closely and give an update about it. What new features there are and what is yet to come? Daytime heart rate tracking is available, and it's been something that is interesting to see. It can show your day when it's been stressing and when it's been restorative time. And this is something I have been checking. I haven't had Apple Watch or something similar to monitor heart rate during the day, so this is good, and it's giving that info of restorative and stressing times on your day. And I really noticed how different days can be seen when watching more typical stressful day and comparing that to, for example, to Christmas Eve relaxation and getting some rest and relaxation like here, and it's showing there clearly. This daytime heart rate tracking has come one of those that I check daily afterwards and see if there's something to do and can you push more or should you have some rest more, for example. At this point, that's pretty much new features there are. Most of the new ones are still yet to come, but let's take a look what there's coming and when. Workout heart rate was set to come late 2021, but it has been since postponed to early 2022. But it's set to support running, walking and cycling, and more to come in the future. You can use the feature by starting a workout in the app and selecting what it is, and when you're done, you enter workout from the app, and then you can see heart rate details from the workout details view. And of course, reward insights after completing your workout. New red LEDs enable blood oxygen measurement, which is very interesting. But this feature will be supported later in 2022. And so far, we don't know how it will be shown in Oura app. But this is something that is already in latest Apple Watch, for example. So the technology for small handheld devices already exists. So we'll just need to wait. For women, there is period detection as a new feature, at least in iOS version of app. Android version is set to come early 2022. Oura says there are 7 temperature sensors that pick up even the smallest changes in your body temperature. iPhone users can already use this feature by turning it on from home screen and need to answer few simple questions to teach Oura about your past cycles. And Oura will get to know your personal temperature rhythms over the next 2 months and will start making predictions about your periods. You can then find a 3-day window for your expected period start date in the calendar view and expect to receive notifications 6 days and 1 day before your expected start date. And Oura says the period prediction is designed to serve individuals with all types of cycles, long, short, variable and regular. My conclusion at this point is that it's okay, some improvements already there like daytime heart rate, and for women there's period detection, and it does have better battery life. But biggest things for this third generation ring are still yet to come, like updated sleep algorithm, workout heart rate and blood oxygen measurement. These all are set to come 2022. Probably workout heart rate will come first of these, as it was already set to come in 2021, but it was postponed to 2022. And that said, be sure to subscribe if you haven't done so, because I'll be checking closely when those new features arrive and will give you reports shortly right after. But that's it for this episode. Please write your comments below. What are your thoughts about new Oura Ring? Or are you planning to have one? Super interested to hear comments about this. And also please hit that thumbs up. It really helps with YouTube algorithms. But that's it for now. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.